Hi, and welcome to another episode of Starship Gaming. Well, Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker has just recently came out in theaters, and I figured today I would do something a little different than what I normally do. I am going to talk about my favorite Star Wars game. Of course, it's already been on the screen for several seconds now. My favorite Star Wars game is Star Wars Battlefront 2. Particularly the original Xbox version. Now, when I was growing up, in the early to mid 2000s, I played quite a few Star Wars games. I believe the very first one I actually remember playing all the way through was Star Wars Episode I, the Phantom Menace video game. But I got really into original Xbox, like, in the early to mid-2000s, Star Wars Battlefront, the very first one, I ended up getting it, Christmas 2005, I was kind of like a year late to the party, and I really loved it, played it non-stop, basically every day, and then a year later, Christmas 2006, once again a year late to the party, I ended up getting Star Wars Battlefront 2 for Christmas. This was the game that defined, it basically defined gaming for me for the rest of my life. This was the game that, it changed everything for me. Like, this game was, when it came out, it was probably one of the most amazing games, you know, up until the early 2010s. I mean, this was one you could come back to time after time again and just play it and really enjoy it. And, you know, a lot of things were similar to its predecessor, the first Star Wars Battlefront. Of course, we are talking about the LucasArts Star Wars Battlefront, not the EA, you know, disasters that those were. But these were the games that defined the mid-2000s, pretty much. I mean, you know, these came out hot on the heels of Halo 2. Of course, the original Halo. And it really, I mean, you could see where it took a lot of inspiration from Halo and, you know, some of the other Battlefield, I guess you could say clones of the time. Clones. Get it? Clones. Yeah. Anyway, I was playing this, and I remember going to school at the time. I was in middle school, I believe, when this came out, and this was all we talked about on lunch breaks, and, you know, every time we had a break, we would talk about Star Wars Battlefront 2, and it was just an obsession, of course. Out of all the people that I went to school with, nobody had the original Xbox version. They only had the PS2 versions. And when I finally had a few friends over to play it, it really blew their mind what, you know, how better the graphics were on the original Xbox version compared to the PS2 version. And for the fact that, you know, the online gameplay, which Xbox Live in the mid to late 2000s on original Xbox was, it was pretty amazing. It was like it was a wild, wild west. Wild, wild west. I don't know why I said that, but it was basically a wild west of online gaming back then. It was still relatively new. And, of course, you had some online-exclusive characters that you could play in Star Wars Battlefront 2. Of course, there was a PC version, which I'm sure looked a lot better, but I didn't get to play it until the mid-2010s, when I finally picked up a copy of Star Wars Battlefront 2 for PC. I think the thing that really defined this game was space battles. Space battles were a very huge part of this. You know, you didn't have them in the first original Battlefront, and it really defined this game and made it different from its predecessor. I think that was my favorite part about this game was the space battles. I like those more than I like the ground battles and whatnot. But to this day, the original Star Wars Battlefront 2 will always be better than the EA Battlefront 2 or even the first EA Battlefront. You cannot make a better game than what the original Star Wars Battlefront 2 is. It will never happen. And now it's time for Steven Says.
Greetings and salutations, how's everybody doing? So, this, Star Wars games, my favorite games, I guess. Like, so the first one I'm gonna talk about is LEGO Star Wars, the video game. This is a game that I loved as a kid. It got me so much into LEGO games. Probably the first one, I guess, of the LEGO Star Wars games. I highly recommend the game. It's really fun. It really is. I mean, just, like, when it comes to LEGO games, this is the game that I basically judge all of the other games on. They say, can you explore a main hub? Can you go through different sections of the game to do blah 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 you gotta do and all that? And yeah, it is a really fun game. I really gotta say that. Another game I gotta say is Star Wars Episode 3 Revenge of the Sith for PS2. It's a lot of fun game. Whereas this one was rated E, this one was rated T. The quality, the effect, the animation for the game is looks like something from PS3. It's really awesome. You can upgrade your characters, make them, wherever it's Anakin, you can make them do force upgrades. Anakin can do force lightning. There's also a, if you do a bit of a completionist, you can get a different ending for, an alternate ending for it, where Anakin becomes the ultimate evil, something like that. Two more games that I also recommend Star Wars Phantom Menace. It's not really my favorite, but for goofy laughs, I kind of recommend it. The animation's alright, but it's PlayStation 1, so we're talking about. And one game that I'm gonna say, I did not buy into this game when it comes out. I did not. But they cannot find into the sequel. I drank it with that one. Battlefront 2. Battlefront for PS4. I did not want this game. I did not. But when it came, but I got it for Christmas, so I thought, okay. Sure. Let's go for it. And I did not like it. Mostly because you always had to be online. But, I mean, if any choices of, like, suggestions of games, I highly recommend LEGO Star Wars, the video game. It's a lot of fun. You'll be able to completionist if you get into this series of LEGO Star Wars games. And also this game too. This game is a lot of fun. If you're wanting a game that's tough and challenging, get this one too. It's especially as a Star Wars, but you can also get Star Wars The Force Unleashed for PS3 too. But that's all I gotta say. Hopefully you enjoyed this, and hopefully Brandon was very informative.
So, that was Steven Says. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. We have one more Christmas episode planned. I know we haven't done very many this year. I hope we can continue after the new year with the whole Copa situation thing. I know it's been a while since I've mentioned that, if you are a frequent viewer. So I hope we can do that, and we have at least 3 more episodes planned after Christmas. Of course, the season 2 finale will be right before New Year's, and then season 3 will begin either January 10th or 11th of 2020, so we haven't really decided yet. So I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps out. It really helps the channel grow, and it helps motivate us to keep going. If we can't keep, if we don't have any motivation, we can't keep going. We can't make new videos, new content. And don't forget to hit the bell to get notifications of when we make more awesome videos. And until next time, I will see you.